says this, we are warmed by the fire and not the smoke of the fire. So our households, our communities, our work organizations, our societies, our nations are warmed and made effective by authentic, inside-out, principle-based leadership. I want you to understand, and I truly believe this, that leadership is not about personal achievements and to be the high performer. It goes beyond performance. Leadership is not about being the expert. It goes beyond expertise. Leadership is not about climbing the ladder of success. It's not about climbing that ladder towards more power and more or more status. It is beyond climbing ladders. Leadership is not even about skills. It goes beyond skills. It's not about knowledge. It goes beyond knowledge. In fact, what it is the expression of your whole self to effect good things in and through others. So the celebration, of course, is what you are blessed with and the fact that you are unique in who you are and what you were given. So love yourself for that. But embedded in that is then always the message, take responsibility for being your own person. Now that is a challenge. That takes courage. But it also builds character and it builds resilience. And it's also where you get your passion from, the fuel for your engine to live towards your purpose in life. So it is difficult, but that's exactly the qualities we look for when we talk leadership. Character, resilience, courage, passion. So taking responsibility for living an authentic life is to step out of the crowd, is to have your time with yourself so that you know where you live an inauthentic, a fake life, and where you are truly the person that you are meant to be. Leadership is, of course, not only about resilience and character and passion, etc., but it's also about unlocking that potential that is given to you. And that comes through a process and a journey of self-mastery, where you constantly challenge yourself in terms of how am I doing in unlocking my potential. And let me stress and say it is unlimited potential, because it's not given to us to put a limit or a lid to our potential with own self-limiting beliefs. And then it's important to understand that with that responsibility and in that moment of making a choice, I'm not only responding to what is coming to me, I'm not only reacting, I am in fact a co-creator of what is coming next to me. So leading yourself towards higher achievement is part of leadership, but that's the poorer part. Be assured of that. The richer part is to participate in something where there's a collective effort and cooperation towards something much bigger and much more beautiful than what you would have had in mind just as an individual. We live in an interconnected world. It is in our DNA to be relational beings. It's in our DNA to love and to be loved. It's in our DNA to work with others and cooperate. The last point is this: you are relevant. It's not for nothing that you have been given a unique design to your life, a unique purpose for your life. It is because you are relevant in this world for as long as you live. But you will find it hard to experience that relevance and to celebrate that relevance if you don't fully participate in this dynamic life by noticing the changes and by living through the changes and by continue growing yourself. I wish you well with your own journey in leading yourself, in leading change, and in leading others by being you.